On May 26, 1566, the future Sultan Murad and Safiye Sultan had a son, Mehmed, who inherited the throne and became the 13th Ottoman Sultan. He was born during the life of Sultan Suleiman the Magnificent. Mehmed III became Sultan at the age of 29. Until that moment, he was a sanjak-bey in Manisa for 12 years. He was the last shehzade who served as a sanjak-bey, because when Mehmed came to power, he did not let his sons out of the Topkapı Palace. In 1583, after his appointment as sanjak-bey, Mehmed left Istanbul for Manisa. There, the concubines bore him four sons, Mahmud, Selim, Ahmed and Mustafa. After receiving the throne, Mehmed became the father of two more sons, Suleiman and Cihangir, who could not survive infancy. Mehmed also had seven daughters, the eldest of them was called Sevgilim. In 1595 his father Sultan Murad III dies. And in order to put her son on the throne, Safiye Sultan hid the death of her husband from everyone, as Nurbanu Sultan did in her time. Shehzade Mehmed received the news of his father's death and left Manisa for Istanbul. Mehmed arrived in Istanbul on January 28 and went straight to Topkapi. First of all, he visited his mother Safiye Sultan in the harem, whom he had not seen for 12 years. First of all, he gave a terrible order, to execute his 19 brothers. One of those sentenced to death, Shehzade, asked to meet with his older brother. But his pleas and requests were cold-bloodedly rejected. Every one of them was killed by dumb executioners. They were buried in the Hagia Sophia garden next to their father. This is how Solomon described the funeral of the 19 princes. On the Sabbath, these innocent princes were washed and cooked according to custom and age, and placed in cypress coffins, and placed on the square in front of the council building. They were buried according to their age around their father, with the weeping of all present. But these deaths were not enough for the newly minted Sultan. After himself, his father Murad III left many pregnant wives. And immediately after his death, two boys were born, who were immediately torn from their mother and drowned. Then, on the orders of Mehmed, 10 more pregnant concubines of the deceased Sultan Murad were drowned, who posed a threat to the new Sultan. Sultan Mehmed III was so afraid that someone would start a war with him for the throne that he kept his sons in Topkapi Palace. Since then, all the shehzadas have not left its walls after their birth. And if earlier all the princes went as governors to the sanjak to get the skills of government, then after Sultan Mehmed they all received only the skills of palace intrigues. After burying all his brothers, Sultan Mehmed occupied the Sultan's chambers of the Topkapi Palace. And his mother Safiye became valide. The remaining wives, concubines and daughters of Murad III, maids, servants and eunuchs were sent to the old palace. Having ascended the throne, a year later, Mehmed decided to go on a military campaign against the Habsburgs, personally standing at the head of the army. This idea was instilled in the Sultan by his mentor Sadat and Khoja. Valide Safiye Sultan was categorically opposed to her son Sultan going to war. She decided to act through Mehmed's favorite concubine, who on the instructions of Safiye, tried to convince her not to go on a campaign. Marco Venier wrote on this occasion as follows, "It was no longer possible for the Sultan to postpone the campaign further. The Sultana mother, angry at her son's imminent departure, convinced a girl of exceptional beauty, about whom he was crazy, to beg him not to leave. She did just that when they were together in the garden one day. However, the Sultan's love suddenly turned into a rage, and drawing his dagger, he killed the girl. Since then, no one has dared to touch on this subject. But Mehmed's desire to overcome the infidels quickly faded after his troops met with the main forces of the Habsburgs. At that moment, Mehmed's nerves gave out, and he was ready to abandon his army and return to Istanbul. But the vizier Sinan Pasha persuaded him to stay. As a result of this battle, the Turks won an unexpected victory. After the victory, Mehmed III returned to a pampered life in Istanbul and never again went on a military campaign. But the war continued in the family circle. Sultan Mehmed ordered the execution of his son Selim. According to one version, Selim openly refused to obey his father. But Turkish sources are strangely silent on this matter. Therefore, nothing can be said about the true reason for the execution of Shehzade Selim. The power of the empire completely passed into the hands of Valide Safiye Sultan, which was very popular among ordinary people. But because of her strong influence on the Sultan, the army and ulama were unhappy. The mothers of the sultans, as a rule, had Jewish intermediaries through whom they conducted their financial affairs. Conventionally, they were called Kira. Valide Safiya also had her own Kira, Esperanza Malki, in whose hands the fabulous wealth of Safiya was concentrated. Paul Ricoat, secretary of the British Embassy in Istanbul, wrote about the enormous influence of the Kira on Safiya. He attributed this to the fact that Safiya and Malki were in a love relationship. In 1600, an uprising of the Saipas arose. They were unhappy that the coins with which they were paid salaries were devalued. The Sipahis blamed Esperanza Malki for all this. They killed her and her eldest son, whom the Sultan appointed as customs manager. 3 years later, the Janissaries also rebelled. They began to demand the expulsion from the palace of Valide Sultan and give them Kappa Agassa for reprisal. They believed that the Sultan was under his influence. Moreover, if their demands were not met, they threatened to remove Sultan Mehmed and put his eldest son Mahmud on the throne. Mehmed decided to satisfy their demands and gave them a Kappa Aga. And he sent Valide to the old palace. But when the passion subsided, Valide Safiya Sultan returned to the Topkapi Palace. However, the threat of the Janissaries to remove him and put his son Mahmud on the throne did not give the Sultan peace. Mahmud enjoyed special respect among the Janissaries. And Mehmed, unlike his young, strong and energetic son, became like a fat carcass. Safiya handed over the intercepted letter, which was intended for Mahmud's mother. And the anxiety of Sultan Mehmed III was only reinforced by this letter. It was from a soothsayer who predicted that within 6 months Sultan Mehmed would die and Mahmud would take his place. The frightened Sultan decided to destroy Mahmud along with his mother. They were executed on June 7, 1603. This was written by Henry Lullo in his letter to the Queen, where he reported that Crown Prince Mahmud was dishonorably strangled and secretly buried. But the first part of the prediction from that letter still came true, albeit 2 weeks late. Sultan Mehmed III died on December 21, 1603. At the age of 38, he had a heart attack. His sultanate lasted almost 9 years. They said about him that he was stupid and overly proud. He was not loved and feared at the same time. He died in disgrace. His subjects did not respect him at all. And no one shed a tear after his death. The Ottoman throne was inherited by his son Sultan Ahmed I, who at that time was only 13 years and 8 months old. I thank you for watching. Give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And continue to stay with me so as not to miss new interesting stories about the Ottoman Empire. See you soon.